back 100%. How are you feeling headed to the ACC tournament?
I'm excited to keep what we're going, what we have it going during the season. Hopefully it translates over to the tournament time. I'm excited to play some postseason games with the fellas, so I'm excited.
Talk about how Coach L manages to stay relevant to you guys, even though he's much older than you, different background from most of you, but he somehow finds a way to keep staying modern and relevant. How does he do that?
He's around us young fellas. He's been doing it for 50 straight years, so I feel like just by default, he kind of has to stay relevant and being around us all the time.
But not all coaches are. Like, there are some coaches that get older and they get cranky and they don't like the way the game is changing. They don't like, NIL, transfer, whatever. He seems to, like, adjust. Would you agree that he adjusts?
That's what the great ones do. They always adjust to circumstances. And we're just blessed that he's our coach and having a great time with
us. Harlond, what's it like to go into a tournament as the number one seed? Everybody will be gunning for you. I know you get a couple games off, but to be a number one seed going into a tournament.
I feel like it's just a product of our work. I'm not going to stop working, so hopefully we can win some games, like I said. I'm confident in all of my teammates, and I'm confident in myself and our coaches. So I feel like that will translate well.
I want to ask about Isaiah.
After Saturday, all the excitement, coming down the nets and everything, how are you guys going to refocus and, in time for the tournament?
That's the first part of the season. We got a lot of games left, so we understand that it's a long season. This is the grind part right here, so feel like we're ready.
I want to ask about Isaiah. Kind of a quiet leader, and what it meant when two things. One is what it meant when he decided to come back. That seemed to give the whole program a lift when he decided to come back for another year. And just what is it about him that you think made him worthy of that award that all those people voted for him?
Regarding him coming back, I think I can speak for everybody that we kind of feel safe. He's on the court with us. We always know that he's going to make the right plays. That means scoring, passing, getting stops. So that's always going to be helpful to have a high caliber player like that on the team. Regarding him winning ACC Player of the Year, that's amazing. Like they said, it's like it's Shane Larkin in the past 10 years. So it's been a minute. So just to see somebody who's worked very hard to get to where he's at, it's really beautiful to see. And we're already happy for him. Very special meetings in my class. So just to be able to see that growth.
Was there any kind of, I know he's a quiet, unassuming, modest type, but was there any kind of celebration you guys did with him or anything for winning that award?
I mean, we were all excited for him. They did it showed us during film, so we all got to see at the same time. So it's a really cool experience for us to share that with him.
Harlond, Coach L always says about regular season at ACC is a marathon. Now he says it's a sprint. How have you seen this message shift from what it was in regular season to what it is now in postseason?
I mean, it's pretty much stayed the same. Same mindset. We always take it a game at a time. So, like you said, we got to take it one game at a time. Whoever we got first, give them our best, play our best, and we'll see how the results come.
Has your mindset personally stayed that same course as far as taking games just day by day?
Yeah, for sure. I feel like it's one game, it's a game, so just got to take it one day at a time. Prepare tonight, prepare tomorrow in practice, be ready by Thursday.
I want to ask how you think the perception of this program has changed nationally. This program, for a long time, even when they played well, never really got the respect. Last year you were not ranked the whole season, and then you end up in the Elite Eight. Do you think that the perception has changed this season, that people actually finally believe that UM is a really good basketball team, a top program? You still feel like you guys have something to prove? Do you think you're there from the national perspective?
I think I can speak for everybody today. I don't think we really look at what other people's perception is, really. Our job is to win games, and minimize the amount of losses that we do take, because it's college basketball, you win these games. So regardless of what their perception is, I feel like our perception has always been that we're a very good basketball team. We know how to win. We have great older players, we have great younger players, that everybody needs to contribute. So that our perception is what really matters. And,
but do you think you're getting, is the program getting more respect now than it used to, just based on the number of fans even that show people writing about you guys nationally?
We had a great coach, so I feel like with him, it's always been your respect from caliber of coach he is.
Harlond, how did the road wins during this season really kind of help prepare you to play in an environment where the majority of the fans, a lot of the times, may be from the opponent?
Yeah, we started off a little slow on the road in the ACC. We got a couple losses that were about like 1 or 2 points. But I feel like that was big for us just to learn how to deal with adversity, learn how to take a loss on the chin and get better in practice the next day and bounce back from that. And I feel like we've done a great job responding to adversity. So I feel like we'll be ready to go to North Carolina where it's a lot of other teams playing there.
Harlond, based on what Michelle was asking, Miami fans kind of frown upon them being known as a basketball school. Like, do you feel like a basketball school? I think you guys have had the most success of any program.
I think we're a great school. I don't know if it's one sport over the other. I know our baseball team is always really good. They always have pros. Our football team really produce pros. So I feel like we're a sports school. I feel like anybody that wants to continue being a professional or play high-level sports, just come on down to Miami. Like you see, it's great weather. We're a sports school, a high-level sports school.
But you still toe that line. You don't want to be known as a basketball school? Is that what we're hearing here? Or?
I want to be known as a winning sports school.
Thanks, Harlond.
Thanks, Harlond.
Thank you. Have fun. Thank you. We tried.
Hey, we can produce well. We got to win championships.
This team has won way more than the football team.
And baseball.
The last 20.
No, I'm gonna get it. In the last 20. Hey. In the last 20?
Yeah.
I'm not gonna ask about that. I'm gonna ask like how was the competitive nature like
started
like by far.
I know I am.
By far.
And this guy.
Elite eight.
No.